We're here with Leon Camier, who's current British Superbike Championship leader at, where are we? We're at Donington. So first of all, let's talk through the first race. Pretty good, went well.
Yeah, it went to plan really. I mean, I thought this was going to be, in fact, we're going to struggle a little more than maybe some of the others. But yeah, top position, which is good. Got a pretty bad start as usual, went back and had a confidence build. Sort of found overtaking wasn't too bad. Getting a rhythm and sort of pull away really when it was cold. Couldn't really argue about it. I wasn't feeling particularly good at the end of the race. Starting to fatigue a bit. So I got a bad case around. Just went back on curve. Carried on the pulling away, but I wasn't sort of particularly right as well. So second race was just trying to recover as much as possible. A load of drinks down me. Just trying to get ready basically. Second race didn't go to plan. We had a restart. But made it a way better for the second restart, and as we sort of got in a rhythm, feeling pretty good. Got past the sport, so it was a really awkward pass, and then lining up Glenn Richards, and as I went past him into the Melbourne loop, I went down the gear pretty early just to try and help me out break it. And as I went down the gear, the rear wheel locked up, and it didn't normally the you want the rear wheel sort of going along with you as well, because it didn't have to slow down, it was locked up solid. I don't know what happened, I thought the bike initially seized or something. The engine cut out as well, and I didn't understand what was going on, so I managed to sort of pull over to the side, trying to restart it, wouldn't have it, had to go to the hospital and walk back on again, and then it went well. Managed to get some points, really, so I put my head down initially, I was exactly relieved, and managed to kick up a gear early on, but just in a bit of a rhythm. The pace was pretty good, still been good enough a bit in front, but also I was a long way behind. So I managed to get a few points for the Yamaha, which was good. Looking forward to the next race, really.
So looking at the next race, Druxton, next round, hopefully you'll be over the man flu. Not much time to prepare, but what can you do in between now and then just to like get yourself in the best possible position?
There's not really any training going on, it's a case of just trying to get back to full health. There's no problem training now, it only makes myself worse. So I'll just have a few days off sleep, maybe fill it out a day or two, do a bit of training, keep them going, and look forward to the Druxton. I'm having forward to the Druxton, it should be a good track for Yamaha, hopefully. It's going to be very, very hard with the hydraulic on the negative bar there, just for our out speed. I'm looking forward to it.
And then just going back to that first race, obviously not involving anyone from the team, but one of your main rivals for the championship, Silvio Mintoli, had a bit of a nasty accident. Just ruled him out for about 8 weeks. Obviously, who do you think is going to be pushing you over these next 8 to 10 weeks for that championship top spot? Who are the main rivals?
James Ellison rode really, really well in that second race. He's far from faster. I think he's going to be a main for. Obviously, I'm really sorry to hear that Mintoli's hurt and stuff. You know, that's just bad. Bad, real bad luck, you know, it can happen to anyone at any point. Things that happen, but it's really bad for the championship as well, and I hope he gets well soon. But I think Ellison's going to be the man to look out for in the next few races. Strong, he's real consistent as well, which is going to be where the development happens. Things happen, you know, that will go.
And then finally, you were here last week having a bit of preparation ahead of some of your rivals with fellow Airways pro Johnny Adams. Any of the tips he give you help you out of the first race, or is it just more of a bit of a laugh to come along and see another motorsport
profession? Yeah, it was just good to go and have a little look at what they do. Amazing how many similar lines they take and similar ideas that he's got, what I've got, what he needs to do on the track. You can, believe it or not, take a lot of the things that I do and he does, and they're really sort of similar and comparable, so it's pretty cool, but I'm just going to sort of carry on going in.
And finally, just obviously we've got 5-6 days between it. Any kind of prediction for the next round? I know it's a tough race, a tough track for us, but...
Oh, I've got no idea. I think Hydrox Underriders will be right up front. I think it'll suit the HM plant on as well. I'm not sure who's going to take the field manager's code again. wait and see. I think it's the usual suspects at the front, but fingers crossed, have a good run there and potentially actually make a career with Yamaha.